Hello, everyone. Hi. Hello. Welcome to the live stream. Oh, my gosh. How are we doing today? I know it's a little early, but I felt like it, okay? So don't get mad at me, all right? I'm just a little girl. Okay, so I decided I want to do something a little different today. Now, I've done like a lot of old Hollywood hairstyles and a couple of different stuff. So let's do something a little more butch. Let's get butch today, okay? Let's do something for the fellas. Or for the ladies that like, you know, to be androgynous. Or just butch it up a little bit. We're going to do more of like a male masculinity kind of hairstyle. Androgyny. Androgyny is the theme of today's episode. Yes. So, let's get started. I have here what we used to carry at Jaymes Mansfield Beauty, the Siren Blue. Ernie has actually ventilated blonde pieces onto it to extend the hairline. And to like, just make it more amplified. Because I feel like blonde and teal look really good together. How are y'all doing? Hello, Francis. Cat, hello. Who else is there? Rob, hello, everyone over on YouTube. And people over there on Twitch, hey, hello. Welcome. Let's do this. Okay. All right, now, first things first, I have to trim this hair so that matches the length of this. So, when you trim hair, you always want to cut in an angle. Especially with synthetic hair, you can't trim it the same way you trim like actual hair because there's no follicle, it's plastic. So you kind of got to be careful with that because if you just trim it straight on, it's going to look blunt. All right, let's do this. I'm making sure it's up and down, inconsistent. Because like I said, it's going to have to lay that way. So far, so cute. All right, this one here. Perfection. All right.
Did you blow dry them
yet? Oh, not yet. I'm going to. Okay, so the knots are fresh on this. So when you actually ventilate a wig, you're supposed to like blow dry or steam the knots so that they tighten up, especially with like synthetic hair. So that's what we're going to do is blow dry the knots to tighten them up a bit. Those of you who dabble in cosplay should know all about that. If you like, if you hand ventilate your wigs. Let's see. Ooh, 2 months. I've been your sub. Ooh, oh, thank you so much, honey. Oh my God. That came out wrong. Well, not that kind yet. Oh my goodness. Oh, you kids keep me young. All right, let's get started. I have the hair all like that now. It's all even length. So let's start styling it. Now, with butch hairstyles, I usually focus a lot of the volume up top, and the rest is sort of just like shaping to create, you know, a look. So that's what we're going to do today. Let me just scoop out this blonde section because I don't want to tease through the blonde too much because blonde can get a little dodgy when you start to tease it. Let's do the teal first.
All right, Carranza on YouTube wants to know, are you getting a sun or a drag queen altar?
Oh, no. I mean, I thought about that for a while, like doing like a male persona, because I think it'd be so fun, like to do like a 50s, like, you know, Bobby Darin-esque kind of like, you know, crooner kind of thing. I think that'd be fun. But no Drag King sons at the moment. I'm kind of all full up as far as children go. I have enough children that barely do drag. A lot of, you know, gay sons and gay daughters. But not a whole lot of drag daughters, just one so far that actually does it on a regular basis, and that's Bryce. And she's so sweet. She actually took my last name, so she's Bryce Mansfield now. She's doing the best over there at Queen. She's a little flippy-dippy kind of girl, just like her mom. You know, like I told you on the pit stop, Mirage Amaro, that was my move. The heel clacks, I invented that. I brought that to Vegas. And if anyone asks, I did that. That was me. Which brings me to a huge topic I wanted to discuss today, actually. I'm glad you guys brought that up. Now, here's the thing. I've talked to you guys plenty of times on these live streams. Those of you who are the real ones, the day ones, know that when I tell you something, you're supposed to take it as fact. I'm infallible. it's the gospel truth, you're not supposed to call me out. And when I ask you to lie and stretch the truth for me, you're supposed to do it. Now, we see who, you know, remembered the code and who forgot it, because on this recent Iconic Blondes, I was being called out for Jennifer Aniston technically not being a blonde. Now, again, this is all up for debate, and I have to say this was a test. This was honestly a test, and a lot of you failed it miserably, because I saw a lot of call-out comments in my section there, and I don't appreciate that. That just tells me people will say one thing and really mean another, and I don't like liars. So yeah, this is a call-out post, too, while we're at it. I'm supposed to be infallible. But yeah, some of you failed miserably, and some of you just knew not to comment, which I appreciate. You know, you let me live in my fantasy and my, you know, lack of research. I just want to style hair, okay? It's all I want.
Your mess on Twitch said, wait, she was definitely a type of blonde. Dirty blonde, I would say.
Oh, that's another thing. People tried to, like, call me out because they said, like, because of my comments about Mandy Morpheus's wig not being blonde. And let me just say this. I catch it as I see it, okay? Like I said, you're not supposed to point that out. Don't bring that up.
All right, I have a comment from Petra the Lesbian on YouTube.
Love the name.
Hey, James. I just bought my first synthetic legs from wig from AliExpress. At the beginning, she looked beautiful, but right now, I'm having a lot of problems because she's getting a little frizz. I've tried many different methods to get the frizz out, but it's still not working.
Okay. Let's see. Have you tried steaming it? Because I feel like that's kind of like, if that doesn't work, the wig just might be, like, junky. It just might not be a good wig.
Also, synthetic is going
to
frizz.
It's always going to, yeah. There's lots of stuff you can do. Like, they have anti-frizz for synthetic. I actually bought that a long time ago. It comes in, like, a little blue bottle they sell on Amazon. Just look up anti-frizz for synthetic wigs, and you should be able to find it. I don't know the name off the top of my head, but there's that. That helps. I used to use that a lot when I did the drag brunch. But generally, if you, like, want to, like, get it nice and somewhat, you know, factory ready again, or as close as you can get to it, the steam is probably the best bet.
Neural Diversity on Twitch said, now who is this beautiful woman? I thought Marilyn Monroe had passed.
Oh my god, thank you so much. Yes, I know. I am Marilyn Monroe embodiment. I should have been in Blonde. It honestly would have been a better movie had I done it, because I would have, you know, looked at the script and said, this is a piece of shit, rewrite it. But poor Ana de Armas, you know, she tried her best with the material she had.
Chris Warnke said, hi James, first time commenting on your live.
Hey Chris, welcome, welcome, welcome. Glad you could make it. We're here styling some butch hair today, so I'm glad you're hanging out. Oh, okay, so with this kind of stuff, when the hair is shorter, what I generally make sure I do is make sure that the hair is packed to the roots as much as possible, because you can only really do much of a base tease, because once you start brushing through it, the tease is going to start going away. So make sure you just pack it to the roots as much as you can. This is like the one time you really can do that. Like, I encourage you to do that.
This neural said, you would have taken the blah out of Blonde for sure.
Oh my god, what a piece of shit that movie was, you guys. But here's the thing, I remember the actual original series with Poppy Montgomery. Well, first off, the book is not good. Like, the book is a piece of garbage too. But the original series was bad too. So, like, when I saw they were remaking that, I'm just like, oh boy, I know this is gonna be horrible. And it was. It's just like, you watch it, it's like, has this director ever even met a woman? Like, is he okay? Does he like women? It felt very much like that.
Tony Tegan on YouTube said, or asked, I know you love WWE and the Divas. Which hairstyle from Sable would you consider for Iconic Blonde? The braid and long pony, maybe?
Oh my god, the one where she was ripping off Madonna? Oh my goodness. Again, being a little kid, you never even realized that was the reference. Like, she's doing Madonna with, like, the braid. Like, here's the thing. Sable had great hair. She was very stylish. So when she would wrestle, she'd have, like, her hair snatched back into a ponytail with, like, eagle claw bangs. and it would be her hair, real hair wrapped up in a bun, and then she'd have a phony pony stuck in the middle of it. And I remember on like an episode of Sunday Night Heat, she got into a backstage fight with Jacqueline, and Jacqueline ripped her pony out and was like wearing her pony on her belt the rest of the night. It's like burned in my mind. It was one of those things where, like, I never really realized what a hair piece was. I thought it was her hair. So like when I saw her rip her ponytail, I'm like, wait, what? How did she, that had to hurt. How'd she do that? And like my sister explained to me, like, she's wearing a wig. Because kids are dumb. But yes, that was a great one. But to answer your question, I probably would do like her glamorous hair, which is honestly, she was just mopping Pamela Anderson. Like that's what it was. Like the full Pam glam without the roots. It's just big old eel claw hair with just beautiful shaggy fall. Like it's so glamorous and so big. I love that. It's very Florida woman.
Do you know your inspiration for the wig yet?
Oh, it's gonna be a little bit like a Linda Evangelista kind of moment. We're just adding the base tees in it right now. I think like Linda Evangelista walking from Mugler, but you know, in blue and my version, whatever I can get towards that. Because with these short hairstyles, there's only so much you really can do. You're gonna try and get the most out of what you got because they're cut short already. So long pieces are gonna be doing a lot of the heavy lifting.
Basic Instinct on YouTube asks, what color palette are you into these days, Jaymes? Love from Europe.
Color palette. I feel like it's kind of always the same with me, isn't it? Like color palette wise. I usually only do like for eyes, blue, purples, pinks, and sometimes green. I stay nude too. I stay within the comfortable middle ground. I'm not very adventurous with my makeup, but I'm trying to be. Like I'm doing different stuff here and there. Like this next video, I did like a floating crease. I haven't done that in a while. Yeah, again, like I get bored with my makeup from time to time, like especially now. So we're trying to like switch it up a little bit. I also have that horrible habit where I'll get like a really cool palette with lots of colors in it. And then I go onto this thing and go like, I'm never gonna use these colors and give them away. And like, wait, now that I actually wanna play around, I don't have those palettes anymore. So yeah, that's my problems, you know. How horrible that has to be for me.
Yamas8 wants to know on Twitch, what's your favorite wig that you've done for somebody else?
Oh, the Moni Cart wig from Trixie Motel was a lot of fun. It was a pain in the ass to like make happen because I never really did a wig like that on that scale. But I had a blast doing it, and like it was really cool to see it like in action and on camera. It looked great. The Trixie Motel promo hair, I did that one. I love that wig. And she's worn that one out. Like the big Raquel Welch, like gigantic hair with like bouffant. Like the, I think it's called like a, it's not so much a blowout. It's a rise. That's what that hair called, that hairstyle is called, the raise. The lift, that's what it is, a lift. Not the raise, the lift.
Andy on YouTube said, girl, you must have some strong arms from all that backcombing, back and crying face.
Just today, Ernie was telling me, like, as we were doing arm day today, it's like, I wasn't really noticing it, but I guess, like, the arms are really starting to pop out now. I just gotta start dieting, so I start to lose a little more weight on my arms. But I don't know, I don't really notice it. I don't notice any of that stuff. But yeah, I guess my arms are kind of strong. Oh, so here, for teasing short hair, another little tip. So, instead of doing your traditional, like, you know, boxer tease, it's more like pushing it down.
Like
forcing it down. Yep. Like we're forcing it down. Because we're basically trying to make the hair all meet at the like base of the head to give it a raise. And that's also going to help if like the hair is like a little see-through in the back or something. It's going to help put a base tease in that to help hide that. Makes it look a little more natural. Or as natural as this can get.
Cat on YouTube asks, have you ever done a hairstyle like Betty Draper's hair when her and Don go to Italy? From Mad Men, obviously. Those type of styles are wild.
Betty Draper. I never watched Mad Men. Although it seems like it'd be right up my alley, right? Like, I never watched it. I felt like it was like, you know, toxic masculinity kind of stuff or something. Like, I wouldn't really be into it. I'll look it up. So, Betty Draper when they go to Italy. Let's see what that is. Like when it comes to like vintagey set styles in the past, they usually like gear towards like Miss Maisel. That's more my jam. Mad Men not Mad Mean, Mad Men, Betty Draper, Italy. Why can't I spell Italy? Okay, there we go. Oh, okay, so it's like an Audrey Hepburn, basically, like the swoop bang with the big old bun on top. I mean, I could.
Send it to the laptop so I can show the people.
Sure, okay. Let me save it. Save the photos. Okay, let me get there. There. No, no. Okay. Technology. Okay. Alright, I'm sending it to you. Alright. I did it.
I didn't get it.
Wait, it said you got it.
No, I just texted.
Oh, okay. That works too. Texting to Ernie. Send. Okay, I did it. But yeah, it's like a Breakfast at Tiffany's kind of hairstyle. We'll talk more about it when it pops up on the screen.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's like Audrey Hepburn Breakfast at Tiffany's almost, like the poster of that. I'm guessing that's what they're probably referencing. That was a very fun, like, you know, casual going out kind of hairstyle. Definitely fun. People love Breakfast at Tiffany's. It's really not my jam. I don't really like the movie that much. Like, I remember watching it during, like, All Stars. Like, it was one of the few old movies they had. Even then, I was just like, fuck, this is boring. But yeah, I don't know. It's a fun hairstyle. Again, not my taste, but I could do it if you guys want to see it. And if you want to own it, I'll sell it. Because I won't wear that particularly. It's not my style.
All right, I'm going to drag it onto the screen. Oh, she did.
She's overtaken my screen.
All right, there she goes.
All right, yeah. But it's totally like Audrey Hepburn in Breakfast at Tiffany's.
Marina used to want to ask, whatever happened to that purple leopard print apron you used to wear?
It's hanging up in my closet. It's retired. Because I wore it out and did everything in it. So yeah, again, like, it's just changing of eras. You know, that was a completely different era ago. But it's still around. Nate Maluna made me that one, who made a lot of my looks for All Stars.
Did you say Nate Maluma?
I think I did. I think I have Maluma on the brain. Must be Maluma on the brain. Yeah. I think so. I think I'm a Luma on the brain. Like, every time I say it, Nate DeLuna, or Nate Luna. He's a DeLuna, like he's Cat DeLuna. Like, wine up. My God, I can't talk today. I'm a mess. I'm gonna drink some Monster.
Pahar wants to know on YouTube, do you ever wear anything besides blonde?
I've addressed this on the Pit Stop before. I'll sometimes wear my natural hair color, which is black. But again, when I do that, people can't handle it. I'm too beautiful. And the jealousy comes out. So I try and like keep it blonde because that's the safe color, you know? I gotta make sure I don't upset the world, you know? It's good to protect everyone's, you know, sanity and safety. Like, national security gets sounded when I do a different hair color. So yeah, that's the reason why. But yeah, that's why. I'm so brave, I know. You're looking bravery in the face right now. Let's start doing pieces. So, I'm gonna do here is drag my brush through, and we're going to start making pieces like this. Okay.
Paul wants to know, if you could never wear blonde wig again, what color would you wear?
I probably would just do brunette. That'd probably be what I do. Like, if I can't wear the color I want to wear, girl, I'll just wear something like, you know, that I'll choose chaos, you know, I'll pick violence. I'll say, the hell with the world. I'll be a brunette now. And again, like, I have naturally brunette hair anyway, so, like, I like to do when I'm in drag to be something I can't really be without a lot of real effort. And I've tried being blonde before, and it's really hard. and it destroys your hair. So that's kind of why I like wear it too. It's just a little fun departure. Plus, Jaymes Mansfield blonde. It works with the brand and image and everything. Although I'm not like an impersonator or anything. Again, I just like how it looks. I think it looks good on me.
I have a question.
Yeah?
Don't you want to cut the blonde sides a little shorter because they're way longer than the blue?
They're going to get there. I'm not there yet. But yeah, they're probably going to get cut. I'm deciding how I want to factor them into the hairstyle first. Because right now we're doing the sides. I'm not doing the sideburns. We're working on the sides right now. Because again, it didn't really pull the teasing up the way I wanted it to. So now I'm just kind of like playing with it. And with this, I gotta make it a little more choppy looking. And like focus on how I'm gonna lay it.
Kyle Bryan sent a $2 super chat and said, here's $2 and that's it.
Thank you, Carl. Carl recently visited us in Las Vegas. Like, his crazy ass drove all the way to LA and everything. Sorry if, you know, Jose didn't know about that, but I'm exposing it now. He did. That's what he did. We went to go see the John Waters exhibit. It was everything. Oh my gosh. Like, I took pictures of Divine and Ricky Lake's costumes. That reminds me, looking at it, Ricky Lake, I'm looking at it, I think she's like the same dress size as me, which means she's like a 16 or maybe an 18. But looking at it, like, she was tiny. And the thing, like, back then when you're watching it, they're just like, she's big as a house. And I'm like, she really wasn't, though. Like, that's wild to me. And I was like, that's like an average dress size. But everyone's acting like, you know, she was the biggest person in the world.
Lil Princess Moo 22 on Twitch said, do you have a Venmo we can tip you on?
I do, actually. Everything I have is at Jaymes Mansfield. It's Venmo, Cash App, PayPal even if you wanted to. Or tip Jaymes Mansfield for PayPal. I have that set up. It's there if you want to, like, you know, donate. Or if you're on Twitch, subscribe. That's nice, too. You get perks with that. Rather than just, like, the nice gooey feeling of, you know, helping me out.
Popo Bandit on Twitch said, hello, everyone.
Hello. Bonjour, ladies. Oh, yes. Okay, yeah. We're going to definitely cut the blonde more. But I'm seeing where it wants to go right now. Oh, yeah. That's going to be sexy. All right, let's trim the blonde some more. Trim some more. Probably end up trimming even more than that too. Oh yes, that's gonna be hot. That's gonna be cute.
Nick wants to know on YouTube, did you make that outfit yourself?
This one, no. This is actually by Velarde Designs. Justin, my gay son. He was my gay daughter, but now he's just my gay son. Because he's not doing drag anytime soon. I can just tell you that right now. A mother knows. But yes, yeah, that's my gay son. He's my designer as well. He just recently did Coco Montrese's green outfit for the Queerties. So yeah, like, little prolific boy there.
Captain Ash19 on Twitch said, hi, Jaymes. You're so talented and I adore you.
Thank you so much. They're singing so nice today. My gosh. Look at that. We're just making the little butchness come out. A little pompadour happening right now. Like I said, like, you gotta work with, like, the hair that they have on top that's long. That's what you're gonna do all the styling with.
Fanch on YouTube wants to know, why do you not set up YouTube subscriptions?
Wait, what? What the hell is that?
I've seen it on your thing, but I don't know either.
I don't know how that works. That's partly why it's not up.
Is it like a Patreon?
Yeah, how does that work? Do you work for YouTube? Explain that to me, because I don't know how that works. That's probably why I don't have it, because I didn't know what it is, and I don't know how it works.
And then we also don't have a Patreon, because we're too busy to keep up with it.
Yeah, when it came to, like, honoring perks and everything, it's just like, I don't have time to do a watch party or anything like that, or let people vote on my content, because it's like, I want to decide what content I do. I'm selfish. That's where I am right now.
Not sure Noble on Twitch said, I thought you were about to say, he just recently did coke. Oop.
Not that I know of. He might sell coke. No. No, no, no.
Lily Sweet 098 just gave you a super chat on YouTube for $50. and said, "Hi, James, enjoying your content."
Thanks, Lily. Oh my gosh. Oh, y'all just coming over to hang out with me in this nice Wednesday?
Yes, Wig Wednesday.
Wig Wednesday, yes. Yeah, I don't know if I mentioned that or not. It is Wig Wednesday. I've lost all concept of time. I was invited to go to an escape room today. What was it themed after again?
Blair Witch.
Oh, that's probably why I didn't want to go. Yeah, if it was like the Saw escape room, I'd have been all over that. Or even the It one, that was fun. But Blair Witch, I'm just like, I think I'm good. I don't want to go to a student film inspired escape room. How's that going to work? We're in Las Vegas. There's no woods here.
Hannah H on YouTube wants to know, do you have a regular performance gig you're at currently, or are you primarily an online girly right now?
Yes, I actually perform fairly regularly at Senor Frog's on the Vegas Strip at Treasure Island. I'm going to be in this Sunday, yes. So if you're in Vegas on Sunday, come and see me. It's going to be a fun time. It's my first time doing, like, I guess, where it's approaching warmer weather. So it's going to get a lot crazier in there, and you're going to see me looking a sweaty mess. So that's exciting. Be looking forward to that.
Ludo Plaque on Twitch said, "Me and my boyfriend love you. He's gonna be jelly at work that I got to see you live."
Oh my God, my throat cleared so severely there. My bad. That's so fun. I'm so glad you can make your partner jealous. That's a great relationship right there. I love that. Be sure and tell him I said, ha 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 ha. Sewing discourse is what I love.
Okay, Fang, sorry if I'm saying your name wrong, said, LOL, it's not like Patreon. It just adds members, chat, and some stickers. I'll look into how to set it up.
Do you want to be a moderator too? I love that everyone's just like, Can you please just be better? like at everything. We'd appreciate that.
I feel like this is where our age is starting to show.
This is our production value, okay? And we're fine with that, all right? I'm fine. I'm owning it. I've accepted the fact that I'm out of the loop, and that's fine. I might argue I was never really in the loop to begin with.
We don't know what we're doing. We just like, well, let's try this.
We fully don't. It's okay. We own it. There's an ice cream truck outside. I hope it's not a serial killer. I always hear that, like, pop go, like, whatever song that is. The da 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 da. What is that? I always think of this, Your Chain Hang Low. Like, that's the seminal song. That's the one I think of. That's the one that truly matters. Has something to say, really.
Francis said, "It's okay, I'm 26 and have boomer skills with technology."
I'm not a boomer though. Like, I'm 34.
You're like, I'm 21.
I had to think about it. I was like, what was my real age again? I was like, yeah. But yeah, like, I'm not even that old. It's just, I'm lazy. And I see lots of text and I'm like, I don't want to read. I don't feel like that. And I don't want to use AI to explain it to me. I'll go through my life in the darkness.
All right, he said, "On Screen has a video on here that shows you how to set it up. All right, we're gonna look into it now."
We're gonna look into it, but I'll tell you this right now. If it's not engaging within the first 30 seconds, it probably is not going to happen. That's how I work. You know, I got TikTok brain.
Brightness on Twitch said, "Hello, love the vibes in here. You're gorgeous."
Thank you. Oh my God, Ernie, he loves the vibes. He loves my vibe. I wonder what that gives off. Like, do I have a threatening aura, you think? I don't think my aura is that threatening. What do you guys think? I'm dying to know. You seem like the types to, like, think about auras and stuff. Crystals, all that stuff. Do we have crystal girlies in here? I found out my friend Carl's a crystal girlie and it cracked me up. Like, he stopped the road trip just to bury a crystal. And he buried it in the Dairy Queen parking lot. So a prosperous thing happened to that Dairy Queen on the route to Los Angeles from Las Vegas.
Oh, James, huh? Are you going for like a pompadour for like the guy that works out at our gym?
That would be cool, but I don't know if we have enough hair to achieve that because his hair is huge. There's a guy at my gym. He has like the most intense pompadour. It's like cropped on the sides and just like, it kind of reminds you of like Paul from Tekken, but like pompadour slicked back. It's crazy. I love it. It's everything. I love a straight man that takes that much effort with their hair. We need more of that.
Someone said, I dare you to go get some ice cream.
I'm not wearing pads, though, or leggings, so it'd be a very startling look from down below. It's just hairy legs.
Yamas8 on Twitch said, even in person, you were really sweet from what I remember, but that was pre-Drag Race, so maybe you've gotten more rotten, I don't know, and then used your question mark emote.
Wow, they're using my emotes against me, but you know, I set myself up for that one. When did you meet me, Matt? How long ago was that? Where'd you meet me at? Was it in Milwaukee? How far back do we go? Girl, I'd be forgetting. I was a drinker back then.
And also, we're reading her screen name, so we would have known.
Yeah, right? That's also a factor. I can tell you right now, I was rotten then, too. She's always been rotten.
Draculas are all evil.
Yeah, they're all evil. I established this, yeah? I made that known.
Nick X on YouTube wants to know, experience questions. Can you do makeup and drag daily? Reason I ask, I cannot shave myself 2 days in a row without rash / irritation without even applying makeup.
Oh, well, honey, I can tell you this right now. I have rash ears. Ugh.
Yamas8 on Twitch said, Milwaukee, my wife was a burlesque performer at the local club / club anything. She did a lot of Sylvia shows back then.
Oh, yes. Okay. Oh, my God. Club anything. That is going back. My God. Jesus. Yes. Club anything. What a great time. Girl, club anything. That was like a goth club that would have drag shows and burlesque shows. The most random crowds in the world, but a good time. It didn't last that long. That was like Horrorgasmo and all that stuff when Sylvia was still doing those. I was like, God damn, Sylvia had a lot of friends. She knew everybody. Ugh. Where are we at time-wise, Ernie?
30 minutes.
30 minutes?
I thought this was going to be a quick one.
Oh, yeah, I know.
Jaymes said, Gracie O was her stage name. She rocked a shaved head.
I do remember this. I do. All right, let's consult my image again. God, this music is so good. Okay.
All right, for now I'm gonna read a comment from Raul Salina Nunez.
Okay.
From YouTube. It said, Jaymes, did you see the Oscars? Did you have a favorite? Cynthia Erivo and Ariana Grande were my favorite of the night.
I did not watch the Oscars because I was filming a video while it was going on. So, like, I got the highlights of everything. Like, I only get, like, who wins. And I also was, like, partly softly protesting because my film Barbie was kind of snubbed throughout the whole Academy Awards. They only won one award. And I think we were only nominated for, like, a few of them. So I felt bad for Margot. You know, I can say this being a big person, like, the bigger person. Even though she got the role that was rightfully mine, I still think she deserved the nomination for it because comedy often gets overlooked. In this case, very much so. To say she wasn't doing heavy lifting for that movie is a very big understatement.
Paul Howard asks, what's the longest you've been in drag? Like, how many hours?
Oh, God. Probably Drag Race, honestly. Like, they have you in drag for hours on it, and, like, those days are so long. Like, I don't even really can recall just how long they are. As far as, like, for a gig goes, I guess, like, filming for stuff, like, if you're doing, like, a movie or something, like, the Be It Still Christmas, I remember I sat in drag from, like, 7 a.m. all the way to 10 p.m. once. Like, that was rough. But we had, you know, trailers and everything, so, like, we weren't, like, dying. We could get out of drag if we wanted to. I'm just always that one where it's like, once I'm in it, I'm in it. And that's my fault. Like, I did that to myself. That wasn't from the fault of anyone else but me. But, you know, I could act like it was someone else's fault. I feel like that's a mature way to go about life. It's everyone else's fault that I made a bad decision.
Should we give them a quick update before I continue reading?
Comment? Sure. Okay, now, as you can see, I'm sitting here styling the pompadour. And we're just trying to, like, make it look cool and stylized. But again, Drag king hair is always fun because it can walk that fine line of like feminine and masculine. And you can have a lot of fun with this, especially like 40s, 50s, and like even 80s hairstyles. They have a lot of like play with like long pieces. And if you look at like the old Hollywood guys, like they'd have like, you know, swirls and waves to their hair that you can exaggerate and have a lot of fun with. This one's going more of like a rockabilly direction because that's just where I live. Now let's take this, cut the piece a little shorter.
All right, Brightness on Twitch says, obsessed with your makeup look, so jelly, love from Sweden.
Thank you, oh my God, everyone's being so sweet today, my goodness. What is up with y'all? Sweden, I feel like I just sent a wig to there, my gosh. Okay.
Floofy Boy Cosplay on YouTube said, I just got the best compliment today from a fellow cosplayer. They said that I'm the Jaymes Mansfield of the cosplay scene because my wigs are always laid correctly. I'm so happy.
I got so concerned when he said the Jaymes Mansfield, like, what are they going to say about me? That makes me feel really good. I'm glad my wig reputation precedes me. Thank you. That's an awesome to hear that, and I'm glad you're getting that compliment. That's super cool.
We have Andrea Next TV on Twitch, first time chat. Hi, Jaymes. You look beautiful.
Thank you, sweetheart. I'm sorry. I got really intense with like doing the hair. Thank you. Oh my gosh. Right, let me show you what's going on right now. We're like playing around with the top area right now.
Right. Travis T on YouTube said, as a drag king and huge longtime fan of you, I'm so excited to see you doing a specifically king-oriented wig.
Ah, yes, thank you. Like, I got inspired because, like, I was watching, like, drag queen tutorials. It's like, I'm so fascinated with, like, how they contour and just, you want to learn how certain things are done and, like, how to, like, actually, like, create a masculine face. And it's, like, enthralling. Like, their channels really, like, are super cool. Who was that one king I was watching? Let me look them up because I really want to credit them. Let me see. They had an amazing channel. Let me see if I can find them. Look it up quick.
Oh, Dick Swagger.
Yes, Dick Swagger. They had amazing content on YouTube that was very informative. I was like, oh wow, yeah, I guess I never thought of it that way. Like super intuitive and like super informative. Cause yeah, I feel like I got this idea because I have a wig that I bought that specifically is supposed to be like Marilyn Monroe, but my head's so big when I put it on. I look like Wayne Newton. Yeah, I look like Wayne Newton. So I was like, I should like a male character with this just so the wig's not going to waste because it was really expensive. So yeah, that's where I got the inspo from. Plus, I feel like there's not a lot that really teaches you. Like there's not a lot of like resources. So I like to dabble in everything.
We're about to start the drag king, era.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, Astro Ranger on YouTube asks, what were you doing with the scissors versus just cutting it straight? Is there a specific reason? I'm curious.
Yes, there is. Now, let me show you something with a wig. Okay, so the bit of hair right here. Now, if you cut a wig the way you traditionally would cut it, like at a hair salon, like flat like that, it's going to look blunt like that. So, the way I cut it is I always cut it at an angle, and it's basically like taking little bites and like... I forget what that term's called, where like you,
That's a feather?
A feather, yeah. You feather it more than you actually bluntly cut. Because the hair has to lay unevenly, because that way, with the fibers of a synthetic wig, it's not going to be blunt. It'll be uneven, and it lays better that way. Like, it's just about the way it lays. You have to kind of cheat it. Everything when it comes to like, you know, actual traditional hairstyling, those rules go out the window when it comes to synthetic hair, because it's a completely different beast. And you can also do that too in between it. If you really want to be sickening, that also helps it lay a lot better. So it looks more like hair. Because it's plastic after all.
Mr. Rancio23 is rating you on Twitch right now with a party of 15.
Yes! Oh my God! Welcome to my channel. I'm Jaymes Mansfield. I style wigs and also play video games here on the channel. Thanks, welcome. Oh my gosh, thanks for bringing your friends.
Mr. Rancio said, hi from Spain, how are you?
Oh my God, hello, yes. What part of Spain? I wanna know. I love Spain, I always wanted to go there. That's in England, right? No, I'm kidding. I know where Spain is. Oh my gosh. Well, welcome. Welcome to the drag. Welcome to the nonsense. We're making drag king hair today. So, pop a squat and have some fun. We're a good crowd over here. Oh yeah, it's getting a little like Landon Cidery now that I'm looking at it. It's cute. Or Jarvis Hammer, very ghostly. Now, for certain sections, what I love about male hairstyles is like you can have a lot of fun, especially when it comes to like covering up holes and stuff, because male hairstyles can be a bit PC. Because they're not really, like, masculine styles aren't known for, like, their neatness. It's supposed to be, it's more rugged if it's not as neat. So you can have a lot of fun with, like, the textures of the hair to make it look more like hair. Whereas, like, with feminine hairstyles, there's a huge emphasis on, like, polish and things being together and neat. I like the, about men's hairstyles, like, you really can just, like, be as goofy as you want with it. And it'll look good. Like, the pieciness is good. It actually just adds to the effect.
Okay, so the Raiders are from like all over the world.
Wow, okay. Hello. My goodness. Well, hello. I'm glad you're here. Oh yeah, I feel like we're almost there with the hair. My goodness. Let me just have some fun with these pieces. This is a little long.
Okay, I don't know if I asked this, but some Christian cook on YouTube asked, if you were to create a video game, recreate a video game character's hair, who would you choose?
Ooh, video game character's hair. Okay, let me think. Sindel, probably Sindel's. Although I don't know if I want to take that on because that's another like super long wig and it's super colorful and detailed, but she's got the most iconic hair as far as like video game characters of my recent past goes, like my memory as a kid. Probably Sindel. Because it's iconic, you know? We all remember the hair wrapping around for the fatale and all that. Or even I guess Princess Peach, she has really iconic hair. There's a lot, actually, when I think about it. Zelda's, you know, ace and convention hair that she has. Those anime wigs that all have Zelda's hairstyle.
Mr. Rancho said, amazing setup.
Thank you. My gosh, I pride myself on that. Now we're slowly working towards just me, a green screen, and just being shirtless. That's the goal. But for now, we're doing this drag thing. Okay.
She's Goofy Boy Cosplay asks, will you ever consider recreating some wigs inspired by Genshin and Peck characters? The hair in that game is always amazing. I feel you'll enjoy styling them.
I'd have to look it up. I'm not exactly sure what it is, but it sounds cool. I'll definitely take note of it. Because I'm not opposed to doing it, honestly. I'll try just about anything. I just also have to like get educated on it because I don't want to sound like an idiot. I just took it on because for the clout. You don't want to ever do something just to, like, get views. Oh, yeah, now we're just having fun texturizing.
Oh, wait, do we have the thinning shear somewhere?
Oh, that wouldn't help anyway.
Oh, okay, then I know you want, like, different little lines.
Mm-mm. We're just playing around. Okay. All right, how's it looking to you, Ernie?
I look good.
Yeah.
Well, ask them.
How do you guys, what do you guys think? What are we thinking? I feel like it looks pretty butch. Nice little butch, like Linda Evangelista-y kind of moment. Supermodel meets drag king.
Oh my God, Jaymes on Twitch said, so who is the off-screen helper? Introduce us.
Oh, that's Ernie. You know who that is. You've met Ernie already. Yeah, that's Ernie. He is my editor slash boyfriend slash everything, honestly. He does everything for the channel. The lighting, does editing, does make sure the like lives are all in like set up, because if it was up to me, it would look a hot ass mess. Okay. Well, Ernie, you can introduce yourself too.
Oh, you already did it for me.
Oh, okay.
Hi, everyone. Okay, so Sakura Carey says, the color reminds me of an Elvis Presley hair.
Ah, yes, love it. Did Elvis have blue hair at some time? I didn't know that. You know, the style?
I think they probably meant, but it kind of reminds me.
A little bit, yeah. That's kind of what I was referencing again. Like, I always go for, like, those kind of hairstyles. They're so easy to, like, get into. Because it's also the most fun to recreate for a drag queen. Because there's, like, there's teasing involved. Like, the pompadours and stuff are a lot of fun. Because it has a lot of the same fundamentals as wig styling for, like, women, too. It's, like, the men's version of, like, doing the most with their hair. The male hair hopper was the greaser.
Veronica on Twitch asks, does the hair already come dyed or do you dye it too?
Oh, this one is synthetic, so it came like this. And the blonde, Ernie actually hand-tied onto the wig. Like, it's platinum blonde synthetic hair he put onto it. Which he did really fast, too. How long did that take you? Like, a few days?
Just, like, a day.
Yeah, a day. Like, he really, really calculated. Like, if he sat down, he probably would have finished it all in one day. But it was, like, with breaks as well.
Well, it was, like, if you count, like, 4 hours, it's, like, it'll be a day, but it's, like, I took a one day break and then the next day I finished it.
Yeah, it's like me with costumes. I'm like, I'm gonna not do this right now.
Oh my god, Duke Maureen said, last time Ernie's introduced himself as, I'm Ernie, I'm Mexican. LOL, iconic.
That sounds like him.
Brightness says on Twitch, it's really pretty. Disney Forest Queen Elf vibes.
Yes, okay. The greaser of, like, Fern Gully. I love it.
One Soul Third Son on Twitch says, hello, James. Didn't know you streamed. Glad to see you on here. Love you.
Thank you. Well, welcome. Hope you enjoy. We're just about wrapping up. I just want to make sure I have everything ready. Oh, my goodness. Let's make sure our volume is adjusting quite right here. Yes, okay. I'm going to have to start blow-drying stuff. But I feel like it's looking kind of fun. It's definitely given, like, a haunted mansion kind of vibe.
Mekon Area said, huge fan from Rio, Brazil. You're such a great person. Love your videos.
Thank you, and welcome to Paige. Alright, this I'm doing here for the, like, the sideburns to create, like, sort of a mutton chop effect. Because that also helps add to, like, the butchness.
Yeah, Matt said, oh, I gotta go back to work now and to interview a potential new hire. Have a good rest of the stream.
Oh my We're god.
To see the final product.
Yes, have a good time at work, sweetheart. Don't hire them. Tell them I said don't hire them. Tell your work, James felt a bad vibe. I shouldn't hire them. Imagine. They come to my stream like, you bitch.
Mudflatboy on Twitch said, hello, James. I met you back at DragCon. Thank you for being so kind that year.
Just that year? Did we have a, was I not nice another year? Don't end a sentence that way. Now I have anxiety about it. Like, how was I the next year? Was like, get away from me! Like a monster.
Mr. Rancio said on Twitch, have to go to dinner late here in Spain. A pleasure to come watch. Big hug.
Thank you! Have a good dinner. Oh my gosh. Okay, so let's spray.
Alright, Soccer Go gave you a $5 tip on YouTube.
Okay.
He said, James, is there anything you can't do? Love your work.
Thank you! My taxes by myself. That I need help with. There's a lot of stuff I can't do, honestly. Like, even the last video I just did, it was one of those things where, like, I had to, like, have a discussion with myself. It's like, okay, I have to get better at doing, like, cosplay kind of hairstyles because it's one of those things where I have to just start challenging myself. Because, like, a lot of the stuff I had to do was, like, very much, like, stuff cosplayers do all the time and just do it with ease. So I have to get better at that. So that's going to be my next challenge, is learning how to do hair like that. On, like, a bigger scale with, like, more unconventional materials.
Mudflatboy on Twitch said, haha, I never went back, love. My apologies.
I love it. Okay. And he said, I saw James. I don't need to go to DragCon ever again. That's what I'm telling myself, at least. That's the end of the story.
Terry said, thank you for supporting us butches.
Yes, we love the butch over here, girl, and she's looking cute. I feel like, yeah, it's giving Haunted Mansion, it's giving, you know, what am I thinking? It's Haunted Mansion meets like Eddie from Rocky Horror meets like a greaser. Like, I like it. I think it's fun. It's got some character. Okay. But yeah, again, like I said, the fundamentals of like male hairstyles like this is like the base tees with these short styles. If there's long pieces, that's amazing because you can play around with those. So always search around for that. Like, you find like at beauty salons or beauty shops, they'll have like those bobs that are like cropped short in the back but have the long pieces up top. Like the long bobs like that. Buy those. They're usually always dirt cheap. And you can start styling them up and playing around with the top part of it. And you can get a lot of really fun hairstyles, like put a roller set in it and you can do like finger waves and stuff. Lots and lots of stuff. He's got, you know, look at things from a different perspective and you'll start finding really cool stuff to make. And right now I'm just playing with little pieces at the end to make it have a little more personality. So like when I turn to the side, they have like personality in the flicks at the ends. Gives it sort of a nice little persona to the hair. Yeah, I think that's cute. All right, well, that is part one. Oh, no, let's do the bang first because the bang's kind of droopy. So, blow dryer. Yeah, also with men's hairstyles, men weren't afraid of a blow dryer. Like the 60s, 80s, even the 70s, like they weren't afraid to blow dry their hair if it has a specific result they wanted. Like if you wanted like an Elvis or a Leif Garrett or, you know, Richard Marx or any of those people who are known for having like really big, glossy, like stylized hair, it was always a blow dryer involved. So don't be afraid of that to like give your hair some lift. All right, but yeah, I feel like this is him. And he's looking really cute. So I think it's time to wrap up this stream. What do you think, Ernie?
I look good.
Yeah.
I think just the bang, you have to just like touch it up a little bit.
A little bit, yeah. It's kind of like going a little bit all over the place. That's also the fun about doing men's hairstyles. Like, it'll get cleaned up when I eventually sell it. Like I said, with men's haircuts, you don't have to emphasize so much on the polish because the messiness also adds to the appeal. Because like I said, men's hairstyles are notoriously not very neat. So it depends on like what the character is. If they're very prissy and pristine, by all means, go full Dracula with it. But if you're doing like Elvis or something, a little rugged is good. It just has to have the right shape. So that's really all you're like to focus on.
Can
all right.
Can I buy this one?
Yeah, yes. This wig will be available on jaymesmansfieldbeauty.com. So if you liked it and you want to own it, it's going to be there. So look out for it. It has a customized hairline by Ernie. So you're not getting a standard, you know, bad wig hairline. It's a good one. He put some time and effort into it. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. Yeah, I think this is fun. Look for it on my website. I'm going to wrap this up so that I can...
Twitch is stuck on the ad right now.
Oh no! Okay, well wait. I'll wait so I can say goodbye properly to them. In the meantime, how are we doing over YouTube? What do you think about Twitch right now? Oh my god. Do you guys think they stink? Oh my god. What are you going to say about them? We have 2 minutes to talk all the crap we want. Unless they're subscribed and they're hearing all of this. Yes. Oh, thank you, Kata. Ernie should try this one on. I have to sell it. It's unsanitary to have them put it on. That's the one downside. Like, you make these wigs and they're so pretty. It's like, I want to wear all of them. But realistically, I shouldn't because it's unsanitary. Then I have to like clean out the wig.
All right, well, Brightness on Twitch wants to know, any tips to get volume and flat hair? I tried flat iron curler, doing the thing with a comb hairspray. It always becomes flat again, lol.
And like a synthetic wig, you think? Or in their hair? I'm curious.
I don't know, they didn't specify.
Oh, okay. Well, honestly, it just depends how you back comb. And if it's short like that, let's see, in flat hair. Oh, a base tease. I have plenty of videos that teach you how to base tease something. It's essentially just like making sure you take the hair at its root and push it down and let it work slowly through your fingers, not dropping it, but work it slowly through.
Said my hair, sorry.
Oh, their hair.
Long hair.
Long hair. Okay, well, yeah, again, you gotta do it in sections at a time. And it's the same kind of style, the same kind of thing where you like, you just, like, don't use this. Use like a comb. And if it's not going down, use a little bit of hairspray. It just might need some traction too. There's also stuff called like volume dust that sometimes help. Like if your hair is especially fine, that kind of stuff could really help. It's like the power you can put in your hair if by all means you cannot get the hair down with, you know, just regular back combing or hairspray. Definitely try that out, and you can just wash it out of your hair. Always detangle your hair before you wash it. Trust me on that. I remember when I had longer hair, I used to the pompadour, and I would just like wash my hair and not detangle it. The matting, ugh, you don't want it. Okay, but yes, gorgeous, handsome, I should say, handsome. All right, folks, thank you so much for watching this stream. I appreciate you guys. And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed on Twitch, why haven't you? It's fun over here. You act like you like sitting through ads. I mean, if you do, that's fine too. But again, you don't have to. Anyways.
Well, you have to make your money somehow.
Well, I know. I'm trying to work my way around that. I want to be like one of those horrible people on Twitch that's just like, you telling me you don't have $5?
I know. We saw a video like that earlier. Like, what is going on?
That cracked me up. She's like, okay, so let me get this straight. You'll buy this, this, and this, but you won't buy a subscription to Twitch. You're home. Like, what is this chick's problem? Horrible. Yeah, I don't want to be that person. Subscribe if you want to. But yes, you guys, I'm being so silly right now. Yeah, thank you guys for sitting through this, and thank you for watching. If you're a king, you learned something, let me know. If there's any other hairstyles you'd like to know that are more butch or king related, just let me know and I'll try and accommodate. And in the meantime, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And until next time, bye.